Hello friends, in this session we are going to discuss what do we mean by logarithm and then we'll go on to its definition. So first we start with basic exponent of the type a to the power x. Now we equate this to n. So we say n is equal to a to the power x. Now what are the conditions for a to the power x to be real? So first of all, for n to be real, x has to be real. The second thing that we know from this expression n equal to a to the power x is if a is positive real, then n is also positive real. Now, the third condition is that a should not be equal to 1. Why? Because if a is equal to 1, and n is equal to 1, then x can have infinite solutions. So this is not unique, right? Because if a is equal to 1, then 1 raised to power 1 is also 1, 1 raised to power 2 is also 1, 1 raised to power 3 is also 1. So we are saying a is 1, n is 1, then x can have multiple solutions. So this is not giving us a unique solution. This is not giving us a unique value for all three. And on the other hand, if a is equal to 1 and n is not equal to 1, then there are no solutions. So we are saying that a should not be equal to 1. How does exponent relate to logarithm? We are having this session on understanding what logarithm is all about, and we are discussing with n equal to a to the power x and then the conditions that it has. Why we are doing that is, now supposing a and n are given to us and we have to find x. How do we do that? Right? We just said that if a is equal to 1 and n is equal to 1, we can have infinite solutions for x. And if a is equal to 1, n is not equal to 1, then we have no solutions. So similarly, if we have different values of a and n given to us, then how do we find out what is x? Can we do that? Say for example, now going to the basic algebra, where we say P is equal to Q into R, and if P and Q are given and we have to find R, can we do that? Yes, R is equal to P divided by Q, right? So we say that we perform a division operation which is inverse of multiplication operation. So similarly, on the exponents, we have to perform some operation which is inverse of this exponent so that we can find out x, right? Similarly, if we are given 2 is equal to 3 raised to power x and we have to find out x, how do we do that? That is where we get logarithm. We define x is equal to log of 2 to the base 3. Now this is where first we started with exponent, and now we are going to move to logarithm to understand what is it all about. So we'll start from where we left. We are saying 2 equal to 3 raised to power x implies that x is equal to log of 2 to the base 3. So we said n is equal to a to the power x, implied that x is equal to log of n to the base a. Now, what does this mean? First of all, let's understand, for x to be defined, for us to be able to find out x by saying that it is log of n to the base a, we'll have conditions. Because in the initial thing, when n is equal to a to the power x, we had certain conditions. So now also there will be certain conditions which will apply. If those conditions are not met, we'll not be able to find out x. So the first condition here again is that a should not be equal to 1. As we said, as we discussed earlier, if a is equal to 1, x could either have multiple solutions or no solution at all. So that means we'll not be able to find out x. So the first condition is that a should not be equal to 1. The a which is base here should not be equal to 1. And the second condition is that a and n are positive real numbers. We said for exponent, we said that for n to be real, x has to be real. So now we are saying for logarithm, for x to be real, n and a have to be positive real. So now we come to the definition of logarithm. Definition of logarithm is that x is equal to log of n to the base a is defined for a and n to be positive real and a not equal to 1. So this becomes now the definition of logarithm, that this will be defined only when this is an operation which is inverse of the exponent, and it is defined when a and n are positive reals and a is not equal to 1. So this comes as a condition for its definition. Now it has two main types. We said that x is equal to log of n to the base a. Now this base could be any number which is positive and not equal to 1. We said that the condition on this is a is greater than 0 and a is not equal to 1, and n obviously has to be greater than 0 also. Now there are, based on this condition, based on the conditions on a, we have two main types. One is called common logarithm, where a is 10. So x equal to log of n to the base 10. This is the form of common logarithm. And then we have Napieran or natural logarithm, where x is equal to, where we can say a is equal to e, the constant e. So x becomes log of n to the base e, and it is also written as ln. So this is ln, represents natural logarithm. So instead of writing log to the base e, we replace this with ln. So either way is fine to represent it. So these are the two main types of logarithm. And for all the practical calculations, we have pre-prepared logarithm table, and there's a specific way to read it to calculate the values of the logarithm of any number. So this is done in a way, there is a specific way to do that. So we calculate, we get this calculations based on the pre-prepared logarithm table. Friends, you can visit us at our Cool Smart Learning website and subscribe to our YouTube channel to get updates on the new sessions.